In this video, I'll be showing you everything you need to start using CorelDRAW. So if you're a CorelDRAW beginner, then this video is for you. Consider subscribing if this video makes any sense to you, and don't forget to turn on the bell so you get notified when I upload a new video like this one. So let's jump straight into it. So for this tutorial, I'll be using CorelDRAW 2021. So if you're using any other version apart from CorelDRAW 2021, you've got no problem because we are still on the same page. Just follow up the process and you understand everything I'm going to show you. So once you open up CorelDRAW 2021, this is what you see, but then your screen may not be this dark screen, but I can show you how to change your screen to a dark screen. So all you have to do is go to tools and you go to options and you can go to customization. And once you do that, this dialog box pops up so you can choose your theme. And you make it either light, medium, dark, or black. So I'm using the dark theme here, and that's just what it is. So this particular screen is known as the welcome screen, where you see your get started, you see your workspace, and you see what's new, learning, and get more. So this is just what you see. And you see a plus icon here where you can click and create a new document. And you see previous jobs you have worked on, previous templates you have worked on just on this place. And what you see next is the file, tools, windows, and so on. But then they are not really important at this point because we want to create a new document. So the next thing you're going to do is to create a new document. So to create a new document, you click on the plus icon and this dialog box pops up. You give your document a name you want to save it with, and you see presets. So you set it to custom and number of pages. It depends on the number of pages you want to have in your CorelDRAW workspace. And then you see your primary color mode, either CMYK or RGB. So you choose the perfect color mode you want to work with. If you're designing for a web-based stuff or something that ends on screen, then you can use RGB. If you are designing for print, then you can use CMYK. Then under your dimension, you see page size. So you have to choose the size you want to work with. I'll leave it at A3. There are other sizes here you can choose, but I'll leave it at A3. And then you're going to see your width and height. So you set your width and height. So you also set the units you want to work with. You can click on inches and that's just it. Then you set your orientation to either portrait or landscape. So it depends on what you want. I'll leave it at landscape, just like this. And your resolution to 300 dpi. Now, why you should use 300 dpi is this. You need to leave it there for a high resolution design, okay? If you are designing for print, then you should be using 300 dpi. And if you are designing for a screen or something that ends on a screen, then you can use 150 dpi. But in general, I use 300 dpi for all my designs, whether for print or a web-based stuff. So the next thing you see is your color settings. At this point, you just have to leave everything on default. You don't have to change anything here. Just leave everything on default and hit on OK. And once you do that, it opens up this page just like what you see here. And this is all the bars, how it looks like in CorelDRAW. And I'm going to explain them one after the other. So you want to understand CorelDRAW interface. So at this point, you see the very first bar, which is known as the menu bar, where you have your file, edit, view, layout, objects, effects, bitmaps, text, table, tools, windows, and help. Okay, so at this point, your file is a bar where you see your new. If you want to create a new document, you see new, you see new from template, you see open, open recent, and so on. So in general, this is where you can always save your job, export your job, import, and do all sort of things. So even your document property is here, and exit also is here. And under edit, you see things like undo, redo, which I'm going to tell you the shortcuts for each of these things in our next video. You're going to learn shortcuts, important shortcuts in CorelDRAW in our next video. So this is just where you see the long cuts for it. Instead of the shortcuts, this is where you see the long cuts under edit. And when you have your view, it's just the way you can set your CorelDRAW to work on your own benefit. You see your wireframe, but in general, always leave your CorelDRAW at enhanced, because that's just the best way to leave your view. And you also have a full screen preview, that if you want to preview your full screen for your design just like this. So that's just it. And you also have other page shutter view, and this option comes only in CorelDRAW 2021, where you have page shutter view and multi-page view. So you can view your document in multi-page. For example, I have like three pages, and you see the three pages are not showing, they show just one after the other. But then if you come to view and click on multi-page view, you'll be able to see the three pages at the same time. So that's what multi-page view does. Okay, you can off that and leave it at that point. So next thing you see is the zoom and zoom out and all other stuff. You see your pages, page border, blade, printable area. You see your grid and rulers if you want to activate your rulers, and you want to deactivate your rulers also. So that's just it. This is the rulers here. So everything about the view, this is where you see even your guidelines are all in this particular page. And the next one you want to see is your layout. Okay, your layout is where you insert page, duplicate page. In general, this layout is all about editing your page. Okay, the page where you are actually designing on, this is what layout does. So the object is just a particular panel you use to edit objects you are working with in CorelDRAW. So for example, you want to create an object, come to create, insert, and all those stuff. This is where you create and do everything you want to do with any object you want to do in CorelDRAW. More about this in our subsequent videos. You're going to learn it one by one. And you see effects. This is where you add effects, 3D effects, adjust, and so on. And this is where you see all the stuff in CorelDRAW, and it makes your workflow very easy. So anything you want to add effects to in CorelDRAW, you just come to effects. In other versions of CorelDRAW, it may not have this particular panel, but this effect is available in your objects. When you come to object, you see where you have effects, or where you have bitmap, you also see where you have effects. So this is bitmap, and you know CorelDRAW works with bitmap also. So this is just what you see. When we start working with CorelDRAW fully, you see a lot of things about that. I don't need to explain anything about text, because you know this is your text tab where you have to edit your text and do everything you want to do with your text. Table, the same thing as objects and tools and windows. Now I'm going to explain some things about windows. Now your windows help you to arrange everything in your CorelDRAW, like what you see, the color palette, the toolbar, and every other bars you see here. Your windows helps you to arrange those stuff. For example, you come to workspace. Your workspace, you choose the particular workspace you want to work with. I would advise you to always leave it at default. And your dockers, this is where you choose properties, objects, pages. For example, if I click on properties, it opens up this panel. Let me do that again. If I click on properties, it opens up this panel where I'll be able to edit particular objects using the property panel. Okay, so that's what that particular bar does. Okay, so you come to windows, come to dockers again, you can choose pages or whatever stuff you want to align and distribute, fit objects to path, and so on. So many things to do here. So in general, if you want to set the things you want to see on your screen, and if any of them disappears, this is where you can always come and make them appear again. For example, if I come to color palette, I can add color palette, I can remove a particular color palette just here. If you click on palette, it opens up this bar. We'll be able to set, now I'm using CMYK, so I'm going to set my RGB. If you click on RGB, it opens up at this particular space here. So that's just what it does. With that, you can use it to set whatsoever you want to see on your screen. If you click on toolbar, you see you will be able to see your menu bar, your status bar, your standard bar, your property bar, your toolbox, which is the particular bar here, and every other stuff you like to activate. So for now, I leave only these ones to be activated. Every other bar works when you click on the particular tool. For example, the zoom, you don't need to activate the zoom, because once you click on the zoom tool, click on Z and the zoom bar appears just here, so you don't need to activate that. That's just what it is. So the next thing we are going to look at is the kinds of objects in CorelDRAW. So in CorelDRAW, there are three types of objects you always see. We have the shape object, we have the bitmap, and the text. And you know, CorelDRAW is a vector based program, so everything you'll be doing will be in high resolution, and vectors, no matter how you zoom them, they don't lose quality. So CorelDRAW is a vector based program. A shape is a vector, and this is a bitmap, which is known as raster in Photoshop, but in CorelDRAW it's known as bitmap, and also the text object. So these are the three objects you always see in CorelDRAW. It's either the object is a text, or it's a vector just like this one, or it's a raster, or you call it bitmap, just like what you can see. So let's look at types of tools in CorelDRAW. And you see the very first tool you see is the pick tool, and the pick tool is just simply to click and move objects around. For example, I have this shape here. The pick tool helps you to click and move objects around and do some editings and transform objects. Okay, that's just the work of Pick Tool. And then we have another tool, which is the Shape Tool. The Shape Tool helps you to edit objects as well. So if you click and hold, you see other tools. Any tool you see this particular angle here, just like this one, and this one, it's just a symbol to let you know that there are other tools under this particular tool which you can use them to edit your object. Okay, and you also have the eraser tool, we have zoom tool. You just have to take your time to study these tools, but I'm going to explain the most important tools you'll be needing for your designs in Corel Draw. So you have the Pick Tool here, which you'll be needing for your designs, and you also have the Shape Tool, you also have your eraser tool, you also have your zoom tool, and you also have your artistic media, Live Sketch, Smart Drawing. So all these tools helps you to work perfectly. So if you're an artist and you like to use this, you like to use the artistic media, the Live Sketch and Smart Drawing to create illustrations or to create vector graphics in Corel Draw. And you also have the freehand tool that can help you to draw anything freehanded just like that. It's very simple in Corel Draw. So you also have tools like the 2-point line tool, and you can click to create a particular line just like that. Very easy to create a line in Corel Draw. So you click and drag and you'll be able to create a line just like that in Corel Draw. It's very, very easy. If you click and hold, you see your paint tool. It helps you to create custom shapes in Corel Draw. And it makes your workflow very, very easy. So let me show you one thing that this tool does. If you click and hold, you will see where you have the smear tool. Let me show you what it does. If you create a shape like this and you like to create some kind of slopey stuff, you click and hold, click on the smear, and with that you'll be able to create stuff like this in Corel Draw. It makes your workflow very, very easy. So that's just what the smear tool does. At your spare time, you can click on each of these tools to see what they do for you. And this is what the 12 tool does. If you have something like a circle, let me use a circle shape like that, an ellipse, okay, just like that, you click and hold and you click on your 12, so you'll be able to adjust that. If you click and get some points like that, this is what your 12 does. Be able to make it okay, you can increase the size of your 12, for example, you have something like that. So it helps you to create things like this. That's just what the 12 does. Just like what you can see, I'm editing this stuff, making it to look distorted. The 12 tool does a very good job like that. Clicking on each of these nodes, you can adjust each of these nodes just like that. So that's what the 12 tool does. And you have other tools like the smudge. And if you use each of them, you see what they actually do. Like the smudge creates stuff like this. It's very easy and nice. So that's what the smudge does. And you can always edit any of the tools to fit what you actually want. For example, the size of the smudge brush, you can increase it here. Let's say we have something like 100. So you hit on enter and this is what the smudge looks like. It depends on what you actually want. And you also have other stuff here, the angle you want it to rotate, the pen tilt, and so on. So that's just what it does. And we have the eraser tool that helps you to erase anything you want. You can increase the size of your eraser just right here, just like that. You can increase the size of your eraser again, so use it to erase stuff in Corel Draw. It's very, very easy and very nice. And there are other tools under the eraser tool, like the knife tool, the virtual segment delete. You can use this knife tool to cut shapes and so on, and just like that. And with the artistic media, it's actually a brush that once you just do that, it gives you this type of media. You can always select any type of media you want to use depending on what fits what you actually want in Corel Draw. So that's just that. And then I'll move away from all these tools and move to where you have the rectangle tool. So this tool helps you to create a rectangle just like that, and it makes your workflow very easy. Same thing with the ellipse tool. That's what it does. If you click and hold on the ellipse tool, you see the 3-point ellipse, where you can create an ellipse tool just like in this pattern you see here. That's just what it does. It makes your edit very easy and very nice. Okay, so you have these 3-point edits just like that. That's what it does in general. That's where you can get your ellipse tool. And the next one is the polygon tool. If you click and hold, you will see your polygon, you see your star, you see spiral, you see common shapes. If you click on common shapes, you will see every other shape you would like to use in Corel Draw. So there are a lot of shapes here you would like to be using, like the love shape and the kind of electricity stuff like that, thunder strike and so on. So that's just it. Okay, so you have other tools just around here, like the impact tool, which is just a new tool in Corel Draw 2021, and the graph paper. So generally this is where you get different polygon shapes. Okay, so that's just what it is. And here you have your text tool where you can type and do a lot of things about your text. Okay, so that's what your text tool does, just to type. Okay, that's it. And if you click and hold, you see your table and you can create a table. I think this works only in Corel Draw 2021, sorry. So that's just that. And if you come down here, you see your parallel dimension tool, you see your connector tool, you see your shadow tool, and you see your transparency tool. So your shadow tool helps you to drop a shadow for a particular object. For example, I want to drop a shadow for this object. I will create the object, click on my drop shadow tool, click and drag, and the shadow drops down just like this. And you see other options here where you can always edit your shadow to meet what you want. You can set the blend mode, or you set the match mode, and you can always set the color of your shadow to any color you want, just like that. You can always set your faders. You can always set your transparency anyhow you want it to look like. So that's just what the shadow tool does in Corel Draw. And then the next one here is the transparency tool. So if you want to add transparency, so you can blend shapes or blend images in Corel Draw with the help of your transparency tool, it's as simple as that. Okay, very simple. And then you click on eyedrop tool. Color eyedrop tool helps you to pick a particular color from a particular shape to another shape. So for example, I'm going to pick this color. You click on your eyedrop tool, pick the blue color and fill it on this other shape. So you have this just like that. And then your gradient interactive fill tool helps you to add fill to a particular shape. For example, that shape can add two gradient fill just like that. And you can always edit your gradient fill here. With everything you see here, it helps you to edit your gradient, something like this. And you see what it looks like. So that's just what it does. So you can always study that at your spare time to see what it works. Okay, so that's just for all the tools. If you want to see more tools, or you want to add more tools to your workspace, you can always click down here and check if there is any tool, or if there is any problem with your toolbar. You can always click on reset toolbar. When you click down here on this particular stuff here, you click on the reset toolbar, or your customize how you want your tools to be arranged in Corel Draw. You can always do that to help you speed up your workflow. So then the next thing I'll be looking at is editing objects. In Corel Draw. So to edit objects in Corel Draw, it's very, very simple. All you have to do is to create a shape. For example, let's use this shape as an example of object we want to edit in Corel Draw. So once you create the shape, it comes just empty with an outline just like that. So what you are going to do is to fill the object with the color. So you like to fill it, you click on any color you like to fill it with, just like that. And if you want to take off this outline, it's very simple. You right click on this particular bar where you have this stroke here, this red stroke just around that. You right click and you click on set outline color, and that is how it works in Corel Draw 2021. So this is it. Okay, and if you want to place objects to the center of your page, you simply place P and it comes to the center of your page. So when you press P on your keyboard, it places the object at the center of your page, and then you start working with it. And then observe this stuff: any color you use in Corel Draw, it will always appear just down here, like what you are seeing here. Just in case you want to use that color again, you always find it here. Okay, so that's just how it is. And then you always see this panel where you'll be able to see the particular color you are using and the color code, or if you're using RGB or CMYK, this is where you can always do that. Okay, so let's study more about this. If you want to fill this object, you click on the gradient fill. I've shown you this before. And you add another color, so you can always edit your gradient. And then if you want to enlarge, you click on shift, and you can always enlarge an object evenly. When you hold shift on your keyboard, you can always enlarge an object evenly in Corel Draw, just like that. And it makes your workflow very easy. And then if you want to tweak an object, you click again. After clicking an object, you see this square node, and you click again, you get these curves around that object. Then you can always tweak the object like this, or you tweak it like this, or you tweak it like that. It depends on the angle you choose. If you hold on any of these curves, you'll be able to rotate the object in CorelDRAW. So that's how it does. And if you hold control, you'll be able to rotate the object in such a way that you'll be able to control the rotation in a very perfect way. Okay, that's just how it is. I'm going to return this back with the help of Control Z. Okay, so that's just that. And if you want to curve the corners of this shape, simply click on your shape tool and you'll be able to hold the corners and rotate, curve it like this. It's very simple. And if you want to curve just one side, you click on a particular node, so it selects this particular node alone and you'll be able to curve just one side of the object like that. It makes your workflow very fast and very easy. And next thing you want to know is how to duplicate objects. So to duplicate this object, I will click and drag and right click before I leave. So I'm able to duplicate this object in a very easy way. But there are several ways to duplicate objects. You can press Ctrl D on your keyboard to duplicate. So when you press Ctrl D, it duplicates the object in CorelDRAW. And then there are other ways you can duplicate objects. For example, lines. If you have a line like this and you want to duplicate it in such of a way of a notebook line, you hold shift on your keyboard, click and drag, and make sure you hold shift so the object stays on a straight line just like this, and you duplicate. So you hold shift on your keyboard to duplicate this stuff like that. And once you do the face duplicating and you press Ctrl D, the object follows that order to give you this straight line. If you continue pressing Ctrl D, it will duplicate to give you what you can see here. So that's just that. So that's how to duplicate objects. And the next thing you want to know is to work with transformation, how to transform objects in CorelDRAW. So if I want to trim or weld or edit objects in such manner, these are things you are going to do. You click and drag and duplicate. So for example, I want to weld this shape. Let's say we have this yellow color. I want to weld this shape with this. Select the two shapes by holding shift, click on the face shape and hold shift and click on the other shape, and then you click on weld. You see these options up here, so you click on weld. So if you don't see this panel here, you can always come to object, come to shaping, and you see weld, trim, intersect, and you see what all this stuff does. So this is what all this stuff does. The weld does a good job by joining the shapes together, and trim does a good job by duplicating the object like this. It trims out the other shape. Okay, so what it does is the shape on top trims the shape below. Okay, so any shape you want to trim, for example, I want to trim this particular shape, I will always select that last. For example, I want to use this shape to duplicate, to trim this other shape. I'll click this other shape first, hold shift, select that and click on trim. But that's how it works. It trims this other shape. But if I want to use this shape to trim this shape, I will click on this one first, hold shift and select this other shape and click on trim. So it's the opposite of that. So that's how it works. And to see other options like intersect will bring out this particular shape at the center just like that. So that's what intersect does. Pretty much intersect is always very good if you want to extract a particular portion of a shape or a particular portion of an object from another object. So you use that intersect, and with that you can always study every other part of this and know what they do. So let's just move on. So the next thing I'm going to show you is how to edit shapes like this. For example, you have your ellipse and you want to create an ellipse. Always hold control to get a complete and perfect circle just like this. If you hold control, you have this stuff in an even way like this. But if you leave your control, your circle will be warped and you have this oval stuff like this, which has no kind of definite shape. But if you hold control, you have a perfect circle. And if you hold shift, you'll be able to create a circle that is kind of even like this, and you leave. And if you want to zoom out or you want to scale up the object, for example, you can always hold the corners to scale up like this. And if you hold shift, you'll be able to scale it in this manner like that, and it makes your workflow very easy. Same thing applies to every other shape or pictures or bitmaps you bring into CorelDRAW. And then I'm going to expose you a little to the property bar in CorelDRAW. If you come to Windows, come to Dockers, and you see where you have your properties, click on the properties, you see all this stuff here. It helps you to edit your shape. For example, you want to give it an outline, click on outline. I'll be able to give this shape particular outline color you want. Let's say black. And that you have given it the color and you choose your outline points. For example, I need 10 points. See how it works just right here. And you can always choose if you want to work with points, millimeters or so on, just what you want. And then you choose the type of outline you want. If you want these dotted lines like that, that's just what the properties bar does. And you can always set your limits, corners, how you want it. If you want curved corners, I'm going to leave this to a straight line so we can see the curved corners very well. Let's set the limit to 20, 40. Okay, let's set it to meter limit to 60. So you see how it curves just around here. And your line caps, if you want it to have a kind of line caps like that. Everything here helps you to edit your outline just like that. So you can always sit on behind fill or scale with object, overprint and so on. So that's just what it is. And you see another stuff here, that is the fill. So if you click on the fill, you'll be able to give this shape a particular fill. You want it to have fountain fill or any kind of fill you like to give it. Depends on what you want. And you can always choose if you want it to have a uniform fill, just like what you can see here, it has uniform fill, or you have a gradient fill like fountain fill here. You want to give it a vector pattern like that. You can always choose different vector patterns, and you can always add your own patterns if you want to. You can see what it does. And there's another stuff here that is the bitmap pattern. So you can always give it bitmap patterns, and you can always add your own bitmap pattern. So this is just how it works pretty much. And there's another stuff here, which is the hatch fill. Okay, in the hatch fill, you see stuff like these kind of pattern lines like that. You can always change the color to match whatever you want, something like that. So that's what the hatch fill is all about. And there are several other stuff here too: color pattern fill, texture fill, postscript fill, and so on. So that's just how it is. If you don't want any fill, you can always click on no fill. So that's what CorelDRAW is all about. CorelDRAW is a very simple program, easy for everyone to use, and it's very, very simple to use. So your transparency here helps you to work with transparency. You want the uniform transparency, it gives this uniform transparency here. If you want your fountain transparency, you want your vector pattern transparency, depending on what you want, it makes your workflow easy. You just have to study this. Once you use it once, and you'll be able to use it again and again and again. So that's what the transparency is all about. And there are several other stuff here you like to be checking in the properties bar. In general, properties bar helps you to transform the particular object or the particular to a stuff you are working with. That's just how it is. Let's move to the next one, which is working with images, that is working with bitmaps. So I'm going to bring in this particular image into this new page, and then we are going to work with this image. So in bitmap, any image you bring to CorelDRAW is known as a bitmap. So then you click on this bitmap, and you can always click again to tweak the stuff like that. And you can always rotate it. It's just the same way to transform objects. So if you want to rasterize or bitmap a particular stuff, maybe the file size is too much and you want to bitmap it, you click on bitmap and convert to bitmap. Then you choose how you want your bitmap to look like. If you want it to be a kind of RGB color and CMYK or so on, you choose your color mode. Then if it has a transparent background, if the bitmap have places you want to make it transparent, you click on transparent background, hit on okay, and it will drop it just like that. Then if you click on bitmap again, you can always edit your bitmap. For example, you want to strengthen your image. Maybe the image was not strengthened. With the help of this stuff, you'll be able to strengthen it to make it look like what you actually want. You can always do the lens distort and set it to whatever you want it to look like, and rotate the image. In general, it's just a way of making your object that was not well perfect. Maybe it was a snapped object and it was not perfect. Then the help of this strengthened image will be able to strengthen the image for you. More tutorials on this in our subsequent videos. Okay, everything here will be more explained in our subsequent videos. I don't want to waste time. I'm just introducing this stuff to you guys so you can start working with CorelDRAW as fast as possible. So if you hit on bitmap again, you see other stuff like edit bitmap, you see resample, you see mode, where you can change either to grayscale, dual tone, palette, lab color, and so on. So if I want a grayscale, just click on grayscale and your bitmap will change to black and white. just like that. So that's just what the mode does. You can always give it kind of black and white stuff, and it, similar to grayscale, it's going to transform itself to stuff like this. You can always adjust how you want your bitmap, or you want your black and white to look like. Okay, it's all based on you. Cancel that, and then you click on bitmap again. You see stuff like inflate bitmap, and you also see quick trace. You see center line. More about the tracing, you see where you have your trace bitmap here. Each time you select a particular bitmap and you want to vectorize that bitmap, you see this stuff that has trace bitmap. So you click, and either you click on quick trace, if you click on quick trace, it's going to trace the bitmap automatically. That's just how it is. So once you are done tracing, this object becomes a vector, just like what you can see, and you can always edit that by ungrouping the object. When you click on the object, you see this stuff where you can ungroup objects, or you can ungroup all, just like that. You click on ungroup, so you can always take off any part of the image you like to take off, because this is no more a bitmap, it's now a vector based stuff, it's now a vector file. So that's just how it is. Okay, so that's how it works. Let's see other objects we can vectorize. If you click on trace bitmap and you see center line trace, technical drawing, these are different ways to trace objects in CorelDRAW. We'll be using this feature in our subsequent designs with CorelDRAW very well, so you learn more about it. If you are enjoying this video and you have learned so much from this video, make sure you leave a like and comment your thoughts about this video. So the very last thing we'll be looking at is working with text in CorelDRAW. It's very simple. You click on your text tool, and once you do that, you can click and type anything you want to see in CorelDRAW. And once you do that, you always see these properties where you can change the font to any font you want. So you can choose any font you want to use. For example, I use this Futura Bold. That's what CorelDRAW does, a very good work there. You will see where you have bold, you want to change the bold, you want to adjust your italics, or you want to make it has a line like that. So that's what it does. You can always see where you can adjust your size, your object size, but I won't advise you to change your size here. You want to change your font size, change it from here. You have 6, 7 points and so on. You can choose any size you want. If you want to rotate, this is the angle, maybe you want to rotate 90 degrees, you can rotate it like that. So that's what it does. But if you don't want to rotate that way, you click again and you have this option where you can rotate your object like that. It's a very free way to transform your text. Then you also have another thing there, that is your alignments. You can always choose the left alignment, center, right, full justify, and so on. So if you centralize this, anything you type down here will always be centralized, just like that. So it's very, very easy and very, very cool and very, very nice. So you can always break your text like that, and if you press Ctrl K, you'll be able to separate two texts that you have broken, just like that. That's what Ctrl K does, to break stuff like that. And then there's another thing you like to know about the text too. If you want to create a text box, maybe you want to type a letter, or you want to type something like the body copy, then you use your text box to create that. And once you do that, all your text will be inside this box, and you can always edit your text box to match anything that you want, just like that. You see where you have your bullets listed, your numbered list, and drop cap. If you want to give a drop cap like that, that's what it does. So that's a little like I can tell you about the text tool. In our subsequent videos, we'll be using more of these features, and we'll start making designs with CorelDRAW. Thanks so much for checking on this channel. It's actually a very new channel and a subsidiary of Dennis Joshua. If you have been following Dennis Joshua on YouTube, that makes graphic design tutorials and graphic design stuff like that, then this is a subsidiary of that channel. And then in this channel, we'll be doing more of CorelDRAW stuff, and only CorelDRAW tutorials will be found here. So to learn more about CorelDRAW, subscribe and turn on the bell, because all the videos you will see on this channel will be based on CorelDRAW. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.